it there. Which way is better for you? Here or there? You said it's there, of course, you said there, right? So people here, you want to put it here or there? No opinion. Here or there?
Right?
How many people? Three people are in a group, right? Two to we call that brainstorming, right? Are you following? 什么叫 brainstorming? 对，脑力激荡, right? Yeah, of course, I'm sure every one of you know a bunch of effective ways of improving or learning English, right? But this is not enough, okay? Because it's a project. I don't want you to just sit there and then you find the answer. You know, just brainstorming and talk about it. That's it. No, no, no. I want you to go outside. In other words, you have to get information elsewhere, not only from your own brain. You see what I'm saying? And then last time I give you some suggestion, I said you could interview someone, right? You could interview me, you could interview, I don't know, you know, some teacher you know, okay? Or your friend, maybe you have a friend whose English is very good and you want to know how come she or he, you know, can have such good English ability. You interview him. Okay, that's another way. And you can make a questionnaire and upload it to Google and inviting people to, you know, yeah, to contribute their ideas to answer those questions. Fine. Or you could go search on the internet and you find something. Okay? So in other words, I want you to do something going beyond yourself. Not just telling me, oh, I know all this. Okay, you see what I'm saying? But you know all this from some other sources. Okay? If you ask me now, without doing any research, I can tell you, okay, how to improve, you know, your English. But then what I want you to do is not just telling me what you know about how to improve English, but you have to show to me that you got this information outside from other people or from other sources. Okay, if it's from other sources, you have to tell me. So therefore, I suggest that in your presentation, since each group has either two or three people, right? So you can divide your presentation into two or three parts. You see what I'm saying? If you have three people, and then your first part could be something like your methods, you know? Like what are the methods you use? In other words, your sources of your information, 就说你的那个资料的来源, see what I'm saying? So it could be the first part. How did you get this information? And you talk about how you collect your information, your data. You got it? So maybe that's the first part. Okay? And then if you interview people, you can talk about who you interview and how many, right? Okay, and then what is your interview question? Maybe you only have one. Your question is simple to say, okay, so can you tell me, you know, in some ways, you know, how one can improve his or her English, okay? So in other words, that could be your first part. And then your second part could be what? Let me know. Your second part maybe would be your findings, right? Okay, after you do this, right, several things, and then the second person will talk about then, what did you find? Okay? And you organize whatever you find. I don't know, maybe into a short list. Okay, and you can you can put the, you think the most effective or the best way on top, something like that. Okay? Alright, and then the third person can give a conclusion. And maybe the person can talk about, you know, your general reaction to this project. And do you encounter any difficulty in the process of doing it? Okay, and then how do you feel? Or have you learned anything doing this? Okay. Yeah, so this is just a suggestion in case you have three people. And then if your group only has two people, and then you can also figure out a way how you share the the job, and then in your presentation, who will talk about what. Okay? So is that clear? Yeah. Okay. All right, so then this is the modified syllabus. As you can see, so since the last class, there's no class, right? So we will cancel this. Oh, so you didn't use, use the version
I mailed. No, this is the latest one I got.
No, I think the version I mailed to you was not the color coded.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't think I got that.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Shall I check?
No, this is not the latest version. But anyway, it's no, this is a previous version. I think I gave you another version. Yeah. But anyway, it's quite similar. But I did change it, I think.
No, under what?
I don't know. I mean, so that's why I don't like Gmail, because they put everything together. It's hard to see. I don't know. But anyway, I made it something after that. That was a really early version, I guess so. You get it later. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Okay, so then, so there's no January 15th, right? So this is the final class. Okay, so we have project, okay, presentation. And I was thinking, we still have a final exam, maybe a short one, okay, which will just take one period, okay, and then I'm not sure whether or not we still have time to do one more topic, okay, so like December 18th, do you see that? December 18th here, okay. And maybe in the first period, we still can do some discussions. I'm not sure whether or not it's a good idea. I think May is against that, right? May thinks that we should cancel that topic.
Oh.
And just do final exam. And another question is the notebook due. Should we have it due here or due in the last week? Yeah, so what do you think? What do you think? Yes, please. You can tell me what, okay. Right? So not because you have So that's why in our department, when we have this kind of presentation, you know, for students, we schedule it on like Wednesday afternoon. We make sure there's no class, right? Because we cannot say, hey, you come to my presentation and you cannot go to the class. It doesn't make sense to me. The teacher will protest, right? Yeah. Do you get my point? Yeah, and then even if you have presentation, then you can ask them to schedule your presentation earlier, like before our class, because our class is late, right? Yeah, and then after your presentation, you can still come to the class. Is that right? So what's your problem? Quick, we are losing time. Yes. You got other idea? Andy?
其实拉姐还是有别的组别的老师，我们很早时间跟他说，我们要早一点晚一点。对啊，可是他们来牺牲你们，叫你们不来上课吧？是，我们没有办法跟他们讲。真的吗？我可以跟他们讲，是谁？你们是什么系？
我们是自学工程。
啊？
好像是
自工程。自工就是我们学部的系，对不对？
好，那我可以去跟我们学部讲说，怎么可以因为你们做这个专题研究，然后不能让学生去上其他的课？ Yeah, it doesn't make sense to me.
原来不是学部吗？那他不是自贡系的老师吗？是不是？
好，之前是，而且现在是。